In the previous video, you saw how to import media into Smoke as well as conform timelines from other nonlinear editors. Now that you have the clips in the media library, let's start sorting and organizing the media. Just a quick note. Everyone has his or her own way of organizing sources, and I'm sure you do too. All I'm going to do is show you the tools, and you can organize the media that best suits your editorial workflow. So it doesn't really matter if you're in the media hub or in the timeline view. At any point, you can rearrange media as you see fit. When you first start a Smoke project, you always start off with one default library. This library is a database where you can store your media and folders. You can have multiple libraries in your project to better organize your material. You can also open and close libraries. This allows you to store media and elements and sequences that you may not want to access all the time. You could use different libraries for versioning, keeping backups, masters, or just optimizing media management within your project by not having everything open at the same time. So a library will always be located at the root level of the media library window. Right-clicking anywhere in the media library will allow you to create a new library. Within each library, you can add folders for further media organization. By right-clicking on the library icon, you can choose New Folder from the pop-up menu. You can give your folder a name and press Enter to confirm. Source clips can be selected individually or in a group. Selection works just like the Mac OS Finder. Select one clip and then shift-click another clip to select a range. You can hold Command to select non-contiguous clips. With the clip selected, you can drag and drop the clips into the folder. At any time, you can click on any folder or clip and rename them. You can also create folders within folders to further manage your editorial workflow. Just so that you are aware, the right-click menu of the cursor contains all the common commands such as cut, copy, paste, duplicate, and delete. Please note that you are not actually deleting your source footage when you delete the clips out of the media library. That is something you would do through the Media Hub file browser or the Mac OS Finder. Now, with all the organization going on in the folders, Autodesk Smoke also has a search tool located at the bottom of the media panel window. Simply type in a keyword, and Smoke will display a list of search results beneath all the media libraries. Incidentally, the Media Hub also has a similar search facility. One important function to note is the connection between the media library and the source viewer. When you select a source clip, it automatically loads into the source viewer. In the media library, the green triangle icon next to the source clip's thumbnail indicates that this source clip is currently loaded in the source viewer. There is no need to double-click a source clip to load it into the source viewer. Simply select it. Now, when a clip is selected in the media library and loaded in the source viewer, you can obviously scrub and play the clip. One function I want to point out is subclipping. If you have a source clip that you have imported into Smoke, which is extremely long, you can mark up the clip in the source viewer by clicking the in and out buttons below the source viewer's navigation controls. Clicking on the clip menu in the top menu bar, you can choose Create Subclip. A subclip will be created in the media library underneath the original source clip. These are ways you can organize media and prepare your clips for the edit. In the next video, we'll look at the source viewer in greater detail.